Tonight I'm going to be lecturing about what the public support of arts and culture, what it's about, what the benefits are, in other words, what the case is for continuing to put public funds into arts and culture. And I go through quite a lot of detail of that because we've been building the case up over the last few years. And I'm going to pick on a few elements of it that need to be unpacked, and I've got lots of exciting elements going forward. What does it mean to be an empathetic citizen? What's the role of a university in arts and culture and placemaking? And how can arts and culture combine with health to make a real difference to people's lives? So some quite interesting forward-thinking ideas, I hope. And in terms of takeaway, I hope people in the hall will engage with that, and I hope they'll go away and really get hold of some of those issues and drive them forward.
The University of Sunderland takes its role as a place-shaping organisation very seriously. Do you think the impact of that is visible enough? Is there more that we could be doing?
I regard the University of Sunderland as something of a poster child for placemaking, urban regeneration. I've been at the Arts Council for 3 years, and one of the early visits I made was to the National Glass Centre. And the University of Sunderland effectively curating the National Glass Centre, pretty well the most important craft centre in the country, was incredibly eye-opening for me. It made me realise what's possible. Now the University of Sunderland is doing other joint ventures. In fact, there's even a press release the day before I arrived here today about Sunderland Culture, which is a three-part coalition between the Mac Trust, the Council and the University. So I'd be the last person to say the University of Sunderland ought to be doing more. I mean, I hope it will do more, but it's really leading the thinking on this, I think.
Given the focus on teaching of STEM subjects, do you still think there's a role for arts and creativity in learning?
We put, as you know, the A for Arts into STEM and we get STEAM. And actually, I think this is pretty widely understood now. And although we haven't changed the EBAC in the education system, and although arts and culture is under threat in some schools, actually there's a wider recognition now that arts and culture is critical to the upbringing and the opportunities of all young people, as it always has been. And I think we're going to make progress on this in the next couple of years.
Just very quickly on your ITV job, congratulations. Do you think that understanding audiences has really helped you in your role between, you know, your TV career and your understanding of audiences for growing arts audiences as well?
If there are any parallels between my background in TV and media, which I spent 35 years in, and the Arts Council, they're not really about understanding audiences or specific projects. What it really has helped me do is speak up for the creative industries in general and define arts and culture as part of the creative industries and see where the parallels are between media, computer games, advertising, all these other elements, and the creative industries, and arts and culture within the creative industries. And so it's seeing the whole, that's what it's helped me do.
Thank you. And finally, what advice do you have for our students who are considering a career in arts or media?
My advice to anybody who wants to work in creative industries is do it. Keep banging on the door, even when it looks hopeless, because if you're determined enough, you will succeed. It is quite casualised. It's difficult to get into. But when you succeed, not only will you be fulfilled as an individual, but I'd argue you'd be doing work of national importance.